In question number 26, a moving hydrogen atom makes head-on collision with a stationary hydrogen atom. Before collision, both atoms are in ground state, and after collision, they move together. The minimum kinetic energy of the moving atom needed so that one atom gets ionized is, so let this is one of the hydrogen atom and it is moving with kinetic energy K. So this is equal to half into m into v square. Let its mass is m and it is moving with velocity v. So the other hydrogen atom is at rest at this moment. Now we know that in order to ionize one of the atom, the condition is half into mu into v relative square is greater than or equal to delta E. So in this case, the reduced mass of the system can be written as m into m by 2m, so m by 2. Since this is at rest, so v relative is equal to v, so v square. And for in order to ionize one of the atom, the value of delta E is 13.6 electron volt. So from here, we can say that the value of K by 2 is greater than or equal to 13.6 electron volt, or the value of K is greater than or equal to 27.2 electron volt. So the minimum kinetic energy of the moving atom needed is 27.2 electron volt. So option 4 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 27. In question number 27, a radioactive isotope is being produced at a constant rate x0. The isotope has a mean life T. Initially, there are no radioactive nuclei. Activity of isotope after a long time will be. So, it is given in the question, at T equal to 0, the number of radioactive nuclei is 0. Then at any time T, dN by dt can be written as x0, that is the rate of formation, minus lambda into N, that is the rate of decay. So, on rearranging, I can write in this way, x naught minus lambda n is equal to d into t. So at t equal to 0, the number of active nuclei is 0, and at any time t, the number of active nuclei is n. So if I solve this equation, the value of n comes out to be x naught by lambda into 1 minus e raised to the power minus lambda into t. Now in the question, it is asked the activity of isotope after a long time. So when T approaches infinity, the value of N comes out to be x naught by lambda. So activity is N into lambda, and which is equal to x naught. So option 1 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 28. In question number 28, for the following logic gates, output X in terms of input A and B can be written as. So this is the input A and B for this OR gate, so the output would be A plus B, and for the AND gate, the input would be A and A plus B. So the output X can be written as A dot A plus B. So if I solve this algebra, this is AA plus AB. Further, AA can be written as A plus AB. Now, if I take A as common, then it is written as 1 plus B, and the value of 1 plus B can be written as 1. So, this is equal to A. So, option 1 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 29. In question number 29, the current gain for common emitter amplifier is 51. If the base current is 0.1 milliampere, then the collector current and emitter current respectively are. We know that current gain beta is equal to IC by IB. So the value of IC is equal to beta, which is 51, into the value of IB, that is 0.1 milliampere. So if I solve this, it comes out to be 5.1 milliampere. Now, the emitter current IE is equal to IC, that is 5.1, plus IB, 0.1. So it comes out to be 5.2 milliampere. So option 1 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 30. In question number 30, heavy stable nuclei tend to have higher N by Z ratio. This is because nuclear forces between neutrons are weaker than between protons. This is wrong. The nuclear force between any two nucleons are same. Neutron's mass is more than that of proton. So this is not the reason. Neutrons decay into proton through beta decay. This is correct, but this is not the correct logic. And in option 4, to overcome the long range repulsive effect of electrostatic force of protons. So this option is correct because in case of heavy stable nuclei, as the number of protons increases, the electrostatic force also increases. So in order to make the nuclei stable, so higher number of neutrons are required to overcome the electrostatic repulsion of protons. So higher number of neutrons are required due to which the nuclear force is able to overcome the repulsive effect of electrostatic force of protons. So option 4 is the correct answer. So by this, I wish you all the best for your preparation. Have a good luck. Thank you.